So welcome to the Stockholm Ladies Curling Cup, coming to you live from the Danderyd Curling Arena, just north of the main city of Stockholm. We're bringing you live coverage today of the game between Isabella Rana from Sweden and Sofana Terzioni from Switzerland. I'm Richard Harding, and with me today I have Armin Harder.
Hello, Richard.
Who is well-versed in most things Swiss, living in Switzerland, Armin. And so you'll be able to give us some
I'll run through
insight.
The Swiss team real quick here. Marlene Albrecht at lead. Esther Neuenschander at second. Manuela Zegrist at third. Silvana Tirinsoni skip. And they're playing out of the Aro Curling Club in Switzerland. I'll let you do this.
Okay. And for Sweden, the Rana team comprises lead player Fanny Sjöberg, Almida Duval at second, Jenny Wallin third, and Isabella Rana skip, and their coach is here, and it is the father of the skip, Mats Rana, who also just happens to be the world senior men's curling champion at this time.
Some curling pedigree in that family.
So, the commencement of the game will begin with the Rana team playing the Bluestones, and Fanny Sjöberg it is to throw the first stone in this game. Eight ends, or I guess less if you're at the wrong end of a big score. And this young team from Sweden are still juniors, but they have been having quite a bit of success in the last few weeks in particular.
I've been very active on the elite circuit even last year, playing five Champions Tour events last year in the with pretty good results, actually, for a very, very young team. Ranked last year 59th on the world team ranking, order of merit.
I think they're already a little bit better than that this time with their wins in Canada.
Yep. Second place in Oakville on the Tour event. This is the opening event of the Curling Champions Tour, ladies' opening event. The men started in Baden at the end of August already. So we've got a very experienced team with Tirinsoni. Swiss well represented at this event here in Stockholm with 17 in total. Just rub that guard. So a good opening here from the leads already, pushing, getting in behind the guard. This one ran a little bit too long. Opportunity here for Albrecht to hit and roll behind the shot rock. These girls come from Zurich. And Manuela Zegrist from Basel originally. Double opportunity here. That one didn't roll anywhere, it just stayed there.
Yeah. just catching the guard, but she does remove one of the Swiss stones. And Almeida Duval
removes her center guard. Terrence Sony having a hammer here in the first end, winning the draw to the button.
But she has left that blue stone out on the left as we look at it. That provides the opportunity for a drawing behind it, which is what Terrence Sony was indicating there.
So that leaves a nice corner guard for Terrence Sony. Lots of ice here. It looks like a big swing.
Yep.
Mike Reed flying in from Switzerland. Do the ice here for the Stockholm ladies. You see that rock starting to move here. But a little generous with that ice, but it is the first attempt of the guard around there. So gotta make sure you get into the house and lay second. Not necessarily wreck on that guard.
Still an opportunity though to spread the stones around the house, depending what happens with this shot. The Swedes will be looking to move the play closer to that yellow stone in the back ring belonging to Tony. This is the second shot of Almeida Duval.
No, that wasn't a little down weight, needed a little more weight, I think. Certainly want to make sure of them in the early stages here. So, Terrence Sony an opportunity to set up three. Schronder. Just trying to split the rings. Doesn't want to set up a double, so she want to be a little bit deeper, make sure the angle is not okay. Tough double there. Play across the top of it, I guess. Just the way she indicated there. Losing their shooter. Terrence Sony currently ranked third in the world in the world team ranking, order of merit.
Who's ahead of her, Harmon?
Rachel Holman, Jennifer Jones. Jones' team here competing this weekend without Jennifer, I believe. But the rest of the team is here in action.
Well, at the moment, things couldn't look much better for Terrence Sony in this opening end. So what can the youthful Swedish team do to rescue themselves a little bit.
Get one.
But leaves her shooter wide open.
Terrence Sony, if she manages to hit this and roll partially behind that guard on the left, really putting early pressure on here.
Manuela Sigrist at third for Terrence Sony. She is reasonably happy to hit and stick. To try to remove two of these Swiss stones with this next shot. So, Jenny Wallin, pretty big weight at it. She got the angle for the two.
Just missed it. And rolls out.
That was close.
Yeah, it was very close. So he's going to lose the shooter anyways, but certainly would have liked to have picked up that back rock too.
So a draw shot now for third player, Mariella Sigrist.
Still giving lots of ice here.
We'll see how much this stone curls into the corner. Not sweeping it. I think it's got plenty of weight. It looks nice and keen, this ice.
Nope, she around
the corner behind the guard. She is. A very nice shot.
Yeah. Started digging into the pebble there. Just finished nice. Difficult decision here for... Do you come down and freeze to that, or do you hit one of those and hope for a miss?
Well, you don't like facing three without last stone advantage, Armin, that's for sure. And that's what they do now. Skip stones remaining here in this opening end.
She needs a perfect freeze, though, to help her at all. Skips first rocks here in the first end, looking at some trouble already.
The first stone in this opening end from Isabella Rana. Critical shot for her, this stone as she passed
the guard. It's not looking too bad if she can't touch that yellow. She does it. Well, that was close to being very good, but it's pretty disastrous there. Just moved a little too much. The weight was looking really good.
Well, I think if she'd got past there, Armin probably would have tapped the back one back, you know, half a meter maybe.
And she might have been partially buried with her yellow one, counting out the two of them anyways.
Possibly not so difficult as all that for Tirinzoni to remove this stone. She won't mind too much if the yellow one at the back goes out as well. I don't think, but she would like to retain her shooter here. Looking for a hit and roll in behind.
She'll probably set up a double, but that'll concede the three for Verano. Pretty tough start here for this young team.
Just the chance to roll in behind there and make it really horrible for your opponent.
Solana Tirinzoni.
The first of her two stones here.
Second on the money list last year. Nice shot.
So two stones remaining here in the opening end. The last one belonging to Solvana Tirinzoni, and Sweden are all set to lose three shots minimum here.
That's about the best you can do, I think. Attempt another freeze, you might give up a lot more. Not the position you wanted to be in the first end.
She's having a look at a freeze, but problem with that is if you don't make that absolutely perfectly, you're probably going to lose five.
Four or five, huh?
Well, that's what she's going for.
Still a lot of game left. I mean, you give up three and you come back with a deuce and it's game's back. This is This is quite a bit of risk taking here, I think.
You need to make a pretty perfect shot. Yeah. If you leave it a little bit wide or easy to remove, then you're in deep trouble.
Three is tolerable, four or five is not the, really what you want. This needs to work this one hard. They end up coming up short. Good they came back past that guard. Ooh.
Well,
didn't leave it in a bad position. It's going to be hard to navigate it out. Might be able to pick it. Four. She's going to lose.
It's,
she might lose the back one.
Yeah, it's actually ended up not too badly. Because if you ping off that yellow stone that you're right next to, you're almost certainly heading straight onto the shot stone in the forefoot.
Well, there was just checking to see who's third shot, because it might be a draw for four here. And certainly a draw for three.
Draw for three, perhaps, yep.
But maybe even a draw for four. No, draw for...
Because actually, if you hit that, you're almost certainly jamming it on the one biting the blue forefoot circle.
I think this is a draw for three, Richard.
Yeah.
But again, if she had doubled them out, she would have that just three also.
Yes.
This was a risky shot.
That's right. So last stone in this first end, a draw shot to outcount the blue stone in the front of the house on the left for 3 points for Tiridzoni. She can't remove that blue to get more than 3 points. They've had a look. They're certain it is three, so from our overhead camera it looks very close. Last stone in the first end here.
Well, Esther seems to think it's good. And so it is. Now good sweepers will take that right to the button just to give their skips. I don't need to take it there. It's there anyway.
So it will be a three count for Team Tiridzoni in the first end. And
they will take a look at this. Might take a look. Do we get a measure? Oh, they conceded. So as you said, Richard, score of three here in the first end.
So welcome back to the second end here in Stockholm, the Stockholm Ladies Curling Cup. I'm Richard Harding and Armin Harder is with me bringing you this live coverage from the Danderyd Curling Arena. Nice 8-sheet curling club. Wonderful. In the north part of Stockholm.
Opening event of the Curling Champions Tour season for the women.
So three shots to zero. As you mentioned in the last end, Armin, 3-0's not good, but it's certainly early enough in the game for you to recover from.
Seven ends, all you need is a score or two and you're back in the game. And with these swinging ice conditions, should see some yeah. offensive play.
Ice looks very nice, actually. Yeah. Fast and swingy. That's what we're after. So, just trying to replace the guard right on the centre line, which Marlena Albrecht achieves. So, about half a metre short of the front of the house, covering the stone on the top 4 foot circle. Second stone here for Fanny Schoberg. So Tironzoni, much the more experienced of the two skips, aged 36. She has been playing for a long time. Knows the game inside out, played at the highest level.
Three-time Swiss champion. At the elite level and a world junior champion. Back in 99.
So nice shot there to lie two from Esther Neuenschwander.
Team's been together a long time too. So they know each other inside and out.
Cutting away a little bit more than expected, hoping to draw in behind, but instead promoting the Swiss stone into the house. So Tironzoni will like the look of the fact that she's got three Swiss stones counting in the rings, but less attractive is the prospect of too many stones being in play here. And that blue one behind. So the attempt here just to raise the yellow onto the blue and remove it from play. Accurate line required. Looking pretty good.
And she pick up the back.
Well, she loses one of the yellow stones, but the danger behind the tee line is now gone. She has set up a double opportunity for Rana and the roll in behind that blue. Little bit of ice, expecting a bit of curl here on this shot. Sweeping madly, I think the stone's curling quite a bit.
Just going to tick and roll off. Gets the one.
So Terence O'Neill now lying two shots. Again in the second end. Chance to lie three. With this draw attempt from Manuela Sigrist. And four stones remaining.
Really moving at the end now. Rock could use a little more handle. Starting to fight the handle a bit. Almost straightening right out there.
Was that about three quarters of a turn all the way down, Marmon?
Yeah, was quite enough. Yeah. If you have an aggressive curl, you certainly need to have enough rotation on the rocks. Otherwise, they'll be very difficult to control.
And ideally, you want a stone and a half's worth of rotation, perhaps, coming down the ice to two stones.
Oh, I would even think a little more would be two and a half to three, probably. And as we go on in the game, you might want to add some more because the ice will start to flatten out a little bit.
Yep.
So you'll need to add a little more rotation to it.
So a frantic sweeping here to get past this guard of front stone of the Swiss. Well, nice shot. She gets way behind. So a couple of possibilities here for Terenzoni. And the front end of the team have come down to have a look.
There's just over 40,000 Canadian on the line here for the event. Winner gets just over 15,000 Canadian. So a nice little chunk of money for first event. Help finance a few more events for the season for the winner. Terenzoni, just to show the difference between the teams from last year, Terenzoni took home about 130,000 Canadian prize money, and Rono about 3,000. So, still young, long way to go. And we're seeing here that the experienced team just continue piling the pressure onto this young team.
Well, choosing to just draw in behind there and lie three stones near the middle of the house rather than hitting the top yellow one as we looked at it on the overhead shows the experience of Terenzoni, because she knows that the scoring zone is a little tighter to the middle of the house when they don't have last stone advantage.
Yeah, and the lots of curls, so you can get in behind those rocks. They're a little staggered, so they won't be able to use them. Just touching it and...
Ooh, that's a bad one.
Well,
and at a bad-ish moment, I would say.
That blue one might come into play now, though.
And the Rana team get a little bit rattled here as the yellow stones pile into the house.
They might need that blue rock now to get out of this end. That might be their saving grace.
The problem, Armin, is it's not that hard to hit the yellow onto the blue and remove it. Now is more danger of it being caught by one of these yellow stones in the...
Well, I'm referring to Verano might needing that rock to push it into the forefoot at the end of the... with the last rock. Terenzoni is obviously not going to take a run at this. That's too dangerous, but she's...
She does lie three, however. looking perhaps to draw behind and lie four. Why not?
They are looking at where that blue rock could go. They don't want to set up those yellows so that they've got no chance of missing anything. So you want to line them up a little bit so that... that's the other option there is what Marlon is indicating. Maybe just guard that. But that leaves that outturn draw that Tirinsoni just played. Leaves that for Ronald.
Well, this is a very long conversation.
There are a few options here, though.
There are. And I think she's selected to come round the outside.
Yeah. She can't take everything away here, so...
No, there's really not much danger in that shot because the blue will not be... Blue stone belonging to the Rana team from Sweden will not be going to hit... the yellow if she comes round on that side, unless she chooses to pick the blue out coming past the yellow one and pick it out going from right to left as we look at it on the overhead picture here. It's another possibility to let you have four.
Just leaves the out turn draw though for Ronald. Come and sit on top of that yellow behind that 12 foot guard.
I was rather thinking of that with the last shot from
I think this is probably the better variation. Just try and get another rock in there. It'd be hard to raise and take out three rocks. And we see a good picture here. There's a little messy in there. Tirinsoni, first rock here in the second end. Trying to turn on the heat.
So using the full width of the sheet there to come into the house and lie four. Well, nicely played.
Yeah, the positioning is good here because she hasn't really spread it out too much. She's kept those two nicely in line. There's still a few holes where that blue one can go through. But Verano's now got to do something here. She's got to end up shot with her next rock. Can she get through that for the double through the port? Is there a double there? Or a straight raise back on the blue one?
Well, depends very much on
I think that outturn through the port, the double is there. Don't think they're looking at it, though.
No, I don't think so. Tough shot, that would be.
Well, she's going to have to make a tough shot here. She's now focused on that blue one instead of maybe seeing the easier option. I think that... We can see that from the... If we can see that from the front again, maybe we can...
So, end number two here in the opening game of the Stockholm Ladies' Cup. And three stones remaining. This, the first of Isabella Rana's shot. Big weight takeout attempt from her.
That rock's fairly open.
Well, she gets the raise to lie in the 4 foot circle, blue circle. First shot, but it's visible for the last stone of Tirinsoni. Two stones now remaining. Of course, this one, and Rana has the last stone advantage here.
Rana's going to have a really tough shot if Tirinsoni makes this perfectly. This is the shot here that I was looking at for Verona with her last one. Of course, that port's a little bit bigger now, and that blue one's over a little more to the left, but I think that option would have been there.
And as you can see from that shot, Isabella Rana can see about half of the stone for removing it. Just controlled takeout weight. Wanted to control the line carefully. if she can hit a piece of this and roll off to the other side of the house. Well, she does, and lies. Nice connection to stop the shooter moving too far. Now she will lie four shots.
I think Ronna might just have a nose hit and to give up, concede one. She doesn't want to roll out. She'll end up giving up two or three.
If she hits that one just off center, she'll move the second yellow.
Yeah, she might end up shot.
Lie first shot.
She's not allowed to roll too far.
Absolutely spot on for accuracy. If she's just slightly off, she could end up giving up one, perhaps. So, facing four yellow Swiss stones, already trailing three shots to zero. This is a big shot for Isabella Rana. I don't think she can see the whole of the yellow stone from the hack where she's viewing from. No, she can't. She can only see about two-thirds of it, so this is very important. She must get past the guard and save her shooter from rolling out here. She's got plenty of weight, that's for sure. Has to pass the guard, very close to the guard, and then hope to save the shooter.
A lot of rotation on this rock. Oh, it's looking pretty good.
Oh, very
nice
good
shot, yeah.
Fantastic shot from Isabella Rana there. Facing four, she hits and rolls to take a single point, and with that, narrow the score from 3-0 to 3-1 after two ends of play. So end number three, we start with the lead player for Sweden, the Isabella Rana team. Let's lead Fanny Sjöberg. So facing lots of pressure in the opening two ends, the Rana team. Sjöberg just coming up short of the hog line there. So Tirinzoni not in any doubt what she wants to do. She wants to play in the house, leading 3-1.
Yeah, I know Tirinzoni can play a fairly simple game here. We've got the two-point lead with the hammer. And it's up to Verano to try and make something happen in this game. Tirinzoni team very capable of certainly turning up the pressure anytime they want. When they see an opportunity, they'll go for it.
Well, immediately onto the sweeping. Tried to hold the line and save the shooter from running out. And they do.
Good work.
Marlena
Elbrecht.
I don't think she'll be too concerned about that.
Not really.
And it's really up to Team Rana to try and make the running here. They need to get the guards in play out in front of the house and try and force an attacking game on the Swiss team. Terenzoni will be quite happy to play defensively. At two ahead with last stone. So the placement of lead stones critical in the curling game. Especially if you're trailing by two.
Well, this the end now comes down obviously to the first lead rock not being over the hog line, so that certainly end up with an open defensive end and maybe take a run at it again for the next. I don't think that nose hit there is what they wanted. They would have liked to have rolled into the house with that. I think that might be a center guard now. And certainly with the swing here, you could actually get around that. But Verano not wanting to toy with that. Would be an opportunity to get around and try and apply some pressure. There's still lots of rocks left in the end. Just exchanging hits here with Tieren Soni. That rock's not in the house. Could have drawn around it. Tony calling for the clear. Doesn't want to leave her own rock anywhere out front. Certainly well, throw a peel away here.
Certainly plenty of weight. And away it goes. I think the Rana team needed to make something with the last stone, not just hit it out of play, because you don't get very many opportunities, and when you do get them, you've got to take them.
That's right. Well, shouldn't have lots of rocks still left to be able to try a move here or something like that.
Well, but you'd don't always have the opportunity available. There's no stones in play, so.
Well, it just makes it easy for Tieren Soni, that's for sure. This is a center guard attempt, looking pretty good. Tieren Soni do anything fancy. Just try and make it disappear. Marlena Zegrist, or Manuela Zegrist.
So back to an empty house. Third player for Rana is Jenny Wallin. Just putting the stone in the house, but it's only going to result in a hit for Zoni and her team. So as requested, let's enroll to the wing, or halfway to the wing anyway, for Team Tiranzoni. This will be the first of Isabella Rana's two stones here in the third end. So we're just trying to hit and stick, move the play back into the middle, I think. Well, goes in the other direction.
Tiernan's only just happy to run this end out and go into the next one. We'll be showing six draws, I believe. Seven this weekend. This is our first. We're on again at 1800.
1800 Central European Time.
Central European Time, yep. And we'll be showing Muirhead versus Hasselborg. Should be a good game.
So the hit was successfully completed by Tiranzoni.
This is a great lineup this weekend. We got Sigurdsson against Jones tomorrow. Coverage. Sidorova versus world champion Felcher in the afternoon, tomorrow afternoon. And then, of course, quarter, semifinal, and final action on Sunday. And trying to get that to roll out.
So she will hit and roll right to the other side of the house at the back. And the last stone of this third end, and it will be played by Silvana Tiranzoni. She won't mind one way or the other, hit and rolling out to hold last stone advantage. I think that's probably what she'll attempt.
Sure.
So there's a good chance to have a go for 2 points.
Maintain that last rock advantage.
But if she hits it on the nose, a 4-1 lead, always a nice one to have early in the game.
Tiranzoni takes one here, she'll feel that would be a mistake. I'm pretty sure she doesn't want that. And she gets it. So blank end. Score remains at 3-1 after three ends of play.
So you join us back here in Stockholm at the Stockholm Ladies Curling Cup, the first of the CCT events of season 2016-17. Really good lineup of women's teams here from around the world. lot of Swiss teams, 7 out of the 20. 2 from Scotland, 1 from Canada.
Russia, Japan, 3 Asian teams here. Russia and Korea and 2 from Japan. Germans, Rundle. And of course, a strong Swedish representation. Playing for a total of well over 40,000 Canadian. The first prize is around 15 or a little more. So we see a good guard here. Now this is a really important rock. This was kind of missed in the first end. It got a little too far, rubbed off the guard, stayed open. So you want to freeze this or get around to the top of that yellow one that's sitting in the top of the house. A big shot here. This sets up the whole end for one team or the other. This is looking pretty useful. There you go. There's a nice shot. That's where she wants it. You'd be pleased with that.
Well played from Fanny Schoberg. So Tiranzoni remains with the last stone advantage here in the fourth end. And she leads 3-1. And a little bit of a game developing in this end early on. So lead player Marlene Olbrecht just trying to follow in this shot. Trying to lie two if possible. Good shot from Albrecht.
So it looks like we got a good end developing here.
So Almeida de Val just being asked to come around here, try and tap the shot stone back.
This looks a little warm. Doesn't get enough of it. Holds the open. Does line up that yellow one behind that blue one a little bit better.
However, the top guard stops that stone.
Yeah, Tiranzoni will be taking a run at this guard now for sure.
It's a straight line to bump one onto the next and eventually to the blue shot, which she's trying to remove from play.
Well, if she hits his right, she might be able to certainly remove the back yellow one. Might
Esther Neunschwander.
She's trying to open it up. Oh, look at that. Sorry.
Well, there was an end of play going on, but I think it may just about have ended with that shot.
I don't think that's exactly what they wanted, but it certainly turned out well for the Swiss team. I didn't think that was possible, get all three of them. Well, the young Swedish ladies are going to have to shake that off and just keep going. They do have a rock out front to work with. So you got to be good to be lucky too, right?
Indeed.
They do have a center guard still to work with. And that rolled a bit too far.
Okay,
might have been better off just to draw behind it.
Nice shot there from Nguyen van der to lie one partially guarded.
So we got seven other games going on right now, just to go through them quickly. Anna Fleming, Scotland against Sidorova, Russia. And that's 2-0 for Fleming right now in the after two ends of play. Coast against Ogasawara. Japanese scored a three in the second end to take a 3-1 lead over Kausta. Muirhead against Hegner. Or is he? Hegner team just coming in at the last minute, replacing the Nielsen team from Denmark, who had to drop out short notice. Muirhead leading 2-1 after two ends of play. And then Millard, Switzerland against Sigfridsson, Sweden. That's 1-0 for Millard after one end. A little bit slow play there, I guess. Matsumura, Japan against Lundman, Sweden. And that game is 2-1 after three ends of play. And then we have Kim from Korea. Useon Club against Manny from Switzerland, and that game is tied up at two each after three ends of play. And then the last game going on, Drindl against Patz, Germany, Swiss, and that's also tied up two each after three ends of play. So a big eight sheet club here. Lots of action on the ice.
Discussion what to do. Tiranzoni lies one, and it's guarded, double guarded.
Yeah. Should draw down on top of it, maybe.
I think that's as good a shot as any. So it's totally invisible from the other end.
I think they're throwing it to the open side. Is that right, Richard?
I think so, and it's probably as good a shot as any in these circumstances. You don't want to damage the position for yourself.
I'm not sure what you're throwing there. It looked like the wrong handle. coming across the top of it because it's curled so much. I just thought they're okay. They were playing the intern on that.
It just needs to stop.
It needs to stop sometime. And it's digging in now. So I thought they were going to play the out turn to the other side, but big swing.
Good shot there from Manuela Sigrist for Switzerland. Tiranzoni looking in strong position here, lying two, and she does have last turn advantage.
I like this call from Rono. She's got lots of curl here, so she can get in behind that rock that's in the forefoot. And those two guards are staggered if she buries this in behind. Tiranzoni's got some tough shooting ahead of her. This is really moving. You can see it.
Well, they need to move this, get it in behind the guard.
Need some legs, too.
It's coming looks up pretty short. Nice.
Oh. Yeah, come up short. Or if they had another couple of meters on that, that would have been buried nicely. But still pretty good position. They had gotten around the back of that. You can almost bury behind the one top of the forefoot.
So three stones remaining here in this fourth end. Beg your pardon. Five stones remaining. Last stone of the thirds from Manuela Sigrist. He's trying to draw another shot into the wing here. I beg your pardon, in round the guard to lie two. Well, pretty nice. Didn't quite curl as much as she would want, but it's a nice shot there. So should the blue stone be tapped, it's not going to connect with that yellow one on the 4 foot.
So she's trying to set up her last shot here. She'd like to get to the face of this and just weld it to it in hopes to. Be able to do something with her last rock.
So the stone of Isabella Rana requires accuracy in the light and the weight. Again, she's playing against a tough team here. Three of the four ends have been left her with quite demanding shots to play.
That's coming up way short, too.
Oh, that's a bad mistake.
Sony can draw on that side too, because that blue one's on the other side. Well, that'll just draw on top of the one in the 4 foot there. It's lay for three. That rock needed to be there.
Oh yes, big chance here for Sony to get a few more stones. 3-1 she leads then, with her first of her two skip stones to come here in the fourth end. And lying two, big pile of guards in front as you can see. So a critical draw shot here from Silvana Tirazzoni.
You can hardly use those rocks, those guards to raise, they're all staggered a bit.
A good looking weight if she could just bring it in. Sweeping madly, quite like to outcount that blue stone, I'm sure.
Is it good enough? Just barely.
Oh, she does. Right. She's lying three shots after that.
It's not a bad place either. I don't really see a lot there for. I draw the back of the forefoot. Wow.
Well, it was just the perfect weight.
Yeah.
So Rana again under extreme pressure here in the fourth end. Lying three against. Nothing to come to down that left-hand side as we look at it from the overhead camera at the other end.
This shows you how important her last rock was. Really got to get full in the back of the forefoot here to have any hopes of coming out of this end. She's got a lot more rotation on her rocks. Let's see that. So those might run a little longer.
Looks a little bit hot.
Yeah, it certainly does.
Too quickly.
It won't break down that quick with that rotation either. And it does, it runs back. The rings. Three, a draw for four.
So Switzerland remain lying three stones here with one shot to come from Silvana Tirazzoni, and it is a free draw for four, which will give them a commanding 7-1 advantage in four ends.
So just clearing with her team what the draw weight is like on that side. Front end was always paying attention to the draw weights. And then skip, good information. Now it's up to the skip to try and translate that into a useful rock. Sweeper's working it. And we see a lot less rotation here from Tirazzoni.
Sweeping it hard. Is it going to outcount the blue stone?
Short.
No. It's going to overcurl and stop short of the 8 foot. And so three shots is the count for Tirazzoni for the second time in this game. And they will assume a 6-1 advantage after four ends.
Jag har inte hört det så länge så det här kan... Nej, jag tror det. Jag får se. sen så bara gör värsta piruetten och bara, oh, ja. Men det var kul. Och så spelade vi bra. Efter...
So welcome back to the CCT Stockholm Ladies Curling Cup 2016, coming to you this afternoon live from the Danderyd Curling Arena in the north part of Stockholm. And we have this opening round match in the C section featuring Silvana Tirazzoni from Switzerland, highly experienced, and the young team of Isabella Rana from Sweden.
Tirazzoni, in the order of merit, the world team ranking. Obviously, they're ranked third in the world. Rana, ranked 33. And there's probably between the top 15 or so, top 20, and the rest, there's quite a gap, I think. In the level of play here, and we're seeing the difference between certainly these two teams. A very young team coming up and learning their lessons against a very experienced Tirazzoni team.
So the corner guard being established by Rana, but Tirazzoni concentrating on drawing to the centre of the house.
Yeah, we're seeing lots of swing. Good curl here. Just trying to cover this one up. Centre guard needs to come over a little bit more. Quite enough. Is she drawing behind the corner guard? That would be nice. There she is. So we'd be peeling this corner guard, Astronorian Schondert has to remove this. And if she hits it right, maybe roll to the middle to cover her shot rock. Just crosses over the top of it.
Well, she can play big weight, Astronorian Schondert.
Certainly can.
Has a pedigree in curling. Her father,
Matt Tirazzoni Schondert.
Yep, played with the famous Attinger team from Switzerland.
Her mother is an Attinger. Swiss curling dynasty.
Yes. So another little mistake from the Rana team there, hoping to come in behind, but just tapping the yellow shot of Tirazzoni's and pushing it over in front of the stone they have in the front 8 foot circle.
Tirazzoni finally got that guard where she wanted it.
Yes. To depend on somebody else, but she got it. So easy for the Tirazzoni team now. They just have to hit this stone in the wide 12-foot circle out to lie two, well, first and third shot, but that won't bother her too much with a five-shot advantage here.
Now they'll just try and reduce the blue rocks lying around and keep it clean. So we'll be showing some great matchups coming up. Another seven games we'll be showing this weekend. Six games in after this one. Another one this afternoon at 6 o'clock. Well, that's almost evening, isn't it? And then two tomorrow, Saturday, and round robin games, and three playoff games on Sunday. Should be some great action coming up.
So the young team now just playing some loose shots, unfortunately for them. I think they've slightly lost the will at five down.
I think the realization coming back against the number three ranked team in the world is... probably not that.
So Manuela Sigrist.
And certainly important to get a couple of good ends out of this to feel good for the certainly for the next game.
That's right.
Make sure you score a couple of points and just try and tighten up some of the things you're doing. Here's a good opportunity.
Yeah.
Just need to get a rock in there. I'm not sure if that's enough ice.
So Sigrist's hit and roll allows a little nest of stones in the back 12 foot, which could be useful for Sweden.
This ice might be a little tight, I think.
It's important to get past these two front guards,
yes,
Armin.
Yes, it is. You don't want to rub off them.
You don't want to wreck onto them. We're sweeping feverishly to make sure it does get past.
It doesn't. Not only doesn't it have the line, it doesn't have the weight either, I'm afraid. It's all over those guards.
Nope, not a good shot.
Well, a little combination of both there, I think. Ice and weight shot. And certainly opportunity for Tyr and Sony to really put the screws.
Well, the Swiss are five up and they lie two in this end at the moment. Big chance to close the end out by blocking in the line with this stone.
This is a little bit short, but it's good enough to be third shot.
Yeah, it's a nice shot because if you try moving it, you're not going to lie third shot. So well played. Chance to get round all these guards though, because none of the stones are really that far into the house. So there's still an opportunity if you play the right line and weight to lie first shot round behind all this front guarded stuff.
This draw out here just becomes a little trickier. Some green ice out there maybe. That's quite a far way out. And the pebble tends to run later on in the game, tends to run out a little quicker outside than it will in the middle. And we see here that it just continues running. It tends to slow down in the middle as the pebble wears down. You get out into the fresh pebble and it runs a little quicker.
Well, she definitely took much more ice with that shot. But
yeah. Well, she had to. That blue guard was obviously over farther over. So.
It didn't curl quite so much.
No.
And of course, it was a little bit heavier, unfortunately, for her.
Yeah. She needed that ice for maybe a little bit less, but certainly you'll be aware that it will run nicer out there. Keener.
Yeah.
So again, so discussion about the weight. Which one?
The first stone here of the skips in number six. Sorry, in number five. Beg your pardon.
Yes, we are.
A great opportunity for Tiranzoni to close out the line that the Rana team were trying to use.
Here we see. Just the difference between the two teams, better weight control. Well, it's reading the ice a lot better.
That's a great shot she's got there.
Yeah.
To lie, I think, three.
That was a right mess there. A little in off, Richard, off that yellow one. We'll redirect. I'm not sure about this ice either.
Well, the whole of the blue circle, all of the 4 foot circle is available to play to still. And there are two Swedish stones remaining, skip stones. So actually, she only needs to play a nice draw round behind, and she could still have the chance to pick up two here. She can make the shot.
She has to get in there, though.
There's nothing blocking her line. She just has to play the right line and the right weight.
That's all she has to do, right?
That's all.
That's it. Yeah. Oh. Curling's such a simple game, isn't it?
Well, potentially this is a simple shot.
Got to get past that guard. A little in off, a little rub, a little redirect.
Oh, yeah. My goodness.
There you go. I called that.
Yes, you did. Not quite like that, I don't think, but...
I don't know if that's what they wanted, but I
should be
that.
Quite happy with that one, well, as the sure result at least.
Probably the best shot of the game so far for
well, best result of the game. Yeah.
Well, it was always there, Richard. I mean, you got a sweep for that. Make sure you don't hit too much of it. It's perfect. That'll give him a few smiles. And Tiranzoni's got hardly a way of getting at that because those rocks are all staggered up front.
No, the only way she can get that is on
off her own.
Double off her stone on the left as we look at it.
There's a blue-yellow raise here too. But that looks a little more difficult. That's a pretty steep angle. So direct.
She can't promote the yellow stone on the... in front of hers because it's being partly covered by the guard right at the top of the
She doesn't need to stick it, just needs to hit it. Just needs to remove it out of play. Of course, if she sticks it, that'd be a great shot. So should be a little weight coming here. Try an angle raise. Take out off her own.
So, tough shot for Silvana Tiranzoni here. Maybe another look at it.
Looks like they're going to change their mind, maybe. Have another look at this.
I don't think there's anything else on here, really.
No, I don't really think so either. It's a pretty thin angle.
Thank you.
So after much discussion, we finally selected the shot here. Sweden's blue counter lying first stone. Ugh.
That was almost made it, but I think the other way would might have been easier, but second guessing obviously. That just very close. Just needed to catch a little more of it. Still a chance here for two. Just need a good draw to the 4 foot. See what one good rock can do in an end.
So can Isabella Rana make this draw shot for two in the fifth end?
Again, we're looking, coming up short.
No, she cannot. And in the wrong line, I'm afraid. So one shot it will be for Rana and her Swedish team in the fifth end. And the score now 6-2 in favour of Switzerland.
We're back here in the sixth end, Curling Champions yep. Tour, Stockholm Ladies Curling Cup. Over $40,000 on the line, 15 to the winner. 20 teams playing in 4 pools of 5. And then Sunday quarterfinals, semifinals, and the final. We'll be showing you a game from one of the quarterfinal games, semifinal game, and of course the final, Sunday evening at 6 o'clock Central European Time. And there's some great teams here this week. Again, Stockholm always attracting really good teams. Obviously see one here with Tier and Sony. We also have Jones' team here. Muirhead
from Scotland.
Pats, Felcher. So pretty well all of the last 5 World Championship teams.
Or World Champions.
Even. World Champions, yeah.
So is there any way back here for Team Rana?
Well, it's still got 3 ends.
6-2 the trail. But they do need to make more shots.
Well, 6-3 actually.
I beg your pardon.
No, 6-2, I'm sorry, that's correct. Yeah. I'll have to steal.
6-2, yeah. Chance to make should it 6-3.
Should have been 6-3, yeah. That would have been a big difference. And you won't see, I don't think you'll see Tier and Sony messing around too much now. They'll just, with a hammer now, they'll just. We're looking at a soft peel here, I believe.
Go, 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 go
And they manage it. Very nice shot.
Yeah. So a clear house to look at for Tirizzoni.
Yeah, that's certainly that.
That's the key objective for their team.
Soft peel is certainly great if you got that in your arsenal.
Well, peeling off the guards, the name of the game. Keep the house open. As far as the Swiss are concerned.
Okay.
And replace that center guard. See, the only way you're going to be able to steal is by getting a rock in the forefoot and getting it covered. This is a little tighter to the rings than they want, probably.
And it could end up leaving the opportunity for a double.
And there certainly is a double here.
Yeah.
The way the game's been going for the young Swedish team. Just not getting the rocks quite in the right places. A little weight control problems throughout. Not really putting this veteran team under pressure.
Yeah. Big weight here, one away perhaps.
No, that's...
big weight, but not big direction.
Not really what you called, but... at this point, any blue rock that's gone is a good rock for the Swiss team. Important to get this in front of their own rock. They've got to work it to get this across the hog line. They work it hard to get it across the hog line. No, that's
nowhere near the hog line.
No, it's just weight control problems throughout the game for the team. That's not going to help them.
No, that's a poor one.
There was an opportunity here to just maybe do something, but that's just disappeared. Should be easy pickings for Manuela Zegrist. Now I wonder with that rock there, might be, why not try to draw behind it? And that's what she's going to do. You put up a center guard or draw behind it, maybe. Got to do something.
Oh.
last year's winner, Rachel Holman. Not here this year. Cheer and Sony won this event in 2013. That's a nice shot. There you go. Needed that a little sooner.
Take out there from Manuela Siegelist.
Might as well keep drawing and nothing to lose. Try and get it behind that yellow one a little bit better.
First of the skip stones here from Isabella Rana here in end number six. 6-2 she trails, but little chance here to use the stone in the front of the house to draw behind, which is
well, really
to do.
Really important here for the Swedish team is to, you know, use these last couple of rocks and try and get some confidence in the draw weight. That's so important for the next game. Right now they haven't had that confidence throughout the game. And if you get some good draws here right at the end, it certainly helps you going into the next one. The draw weight's everything. You don't have confidence in draw weight, you're not doing anything well.
No.
It's like a pitcher finding the strike zone. If you can't find the strike zone, you can throw the nicest pitches. It doesn't make any difference. Yeah, you don't know anything about baseball, do you?
Correct.
Cricket, maybe.
Now we're talking.
Okay.
So. Controlled weight take out from Terenzoni here. Shooter, will it remain?
And again, we see nice controlled weight. That's why draw weight is important. Even those hits need controlled weight.
So no pressure for Sovana Tirantoni in her opening game here. Lying 2 and 6-2 ahead. And she has last turn advantage here, so Sweden's in a little bit more bother.
It stops now.
Well, she's got a great looking weight and line there.
There we go.
And lies nicely.
Yeah, she'll be pleased with those last two rocks for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Particularly that one.
Well, this forces Tirantoni to a draw. I think if she makes it, it'll be a 5-point difference. Team just asking exactly where that rock is. That's pretty important to them because they have to sweep this. Some positive words there from the front end.
So last stone here in end number six. And draw shot. This is the first time really that Tirantoni's been under any particular pressure in an end. She's obviously not under too much pressure in the game, but she's having to make a shot here for her single point. And it looks spot on line to go to that backstone of Sweden's Talai one. Well, not even. She draws the button. And well played by Silvana Tirazzoni and her team with that draw shot. She takes a single point. And the young Swedish team have decided to call it a day. 7-2, the score at the finish in 6 ends of play. And Tirazzoni will march into the next round with a confident victory from their first game here in Stockholm.
Yeah, I think the those young Swedish team was good to was good for them to find the draw weight at the end. That score is 7-2. So it was good for them for the next games to get that confidence. So it was important the last end for them.
So with that score of 7-2, Tirazzoni overcoming the youth of Team Rana from Sweden. They will go into the next round with a 1-0 record, Rana 0-1. Other games remaining, but for us this afternoon, me, Richard Harding, and Armin Harder, it's a very good afternoon from Stockholm and the CCT Stockholm Ladies Curling Cup. Come back to join us at 6 p.m. tonight, European time, for
we'll see you
matchup.
Then.